so undeserved that you made to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. Is that good to me? All that I am.
All right, we're good.
Thank you.
She lost her husband, Rick. Thank you. And as you know, losing any family member, it's rough, but especially a spouse, somebody you've been with for a long, long time. So, Rebecca, if you're watching today, we love you. We lift you up. We honor you today. So know that you are loved. Announcements this week. First of all, if you are a first-time visitor, we are so glad that you have chosen to spend your Sunday with us. And if this is your very first time coming to Unity, could you put your hand up about this high? Just so we can acknowledge you, we've got some information we'd love to give you. And it looks like that we're all family here today. So thank you. But guys, guess what? This is a great opportunity to invite your friends to come and join us. And if everybody invited one person, we would have double the number we've got today. So just something to think about. So very happy about that. You know, one of the many things that I love about Unity Church is that we are a praying church. And if you have prayer needs today, we have a prayer box in the narthex that you can certainly write your prayer concerns down. And Pastor Elizabeth will pray over those for 7 days. And then we'll send those to Unity in Missouri so they can be prayed over for 30 days. So that's a good thing. And if you've got an immediate prayer need, please, please come up after the service here to the front. We would love to meet with you and to pray with you. That would be wonderful. God bless you guys for that. You know, because it's coming up Thanksgiving, this Wednesday night, there will be no yoga, no meditation. So we bless you guys to go and spend it with your family. Bless you guys to set in gratitude for what you're thankful for. And we hope that you all have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. So no service this week. We want to thank you to everyone who helped out with our gratitude lunch last Sunday. I wasn't here. I was hosting a spiritual retreat. We had a wonderful time at the retreat. But for those that were here, I heard that it was a wonderful time. So thank you for all the food, for the good fellowship. God bless each and every one of you guys. We are going to be putting up the Christmas tree in the lobby next Sunday after church, the 27th. So I can't believe that we're here talking about Christmas already. But if you've listened to the radio at all, they think they started playing Christmas music on November 1st. So it's already been a while. It's already been around for a while. But next Sunday after church, if you would be willing to hang around and to help us decorate the sanctuary here and the lobby for Christmas, that'd be great. Now, with that Christmas tree, it's a really great opportunity because we are doing an amazing fundraiser for our church. And basically, we're going to have Christmas stars and Christmas angels, somebody that has brought you light in your life, somebody that's brought you love in your life, that you're going to be able to fill their name out on a star or an angel. And we are asking, because it is a fundraiser, for just a small donation of $5 to be able to honor yourself, maybe Pastor Elizabeth, maybe your friends and loved ones. You could even put one up there for Jesus. I think he would like that too. That'd be fine. But it's just a great way to be able to do that. And we'll have those stars and those angels that you can write those names, and we can attach it to the Christmas tree out there. And I think it'd be a great, fun way just to be able to acknowledge and honor everybody here in the sanctuary and to your wonderful family and to help contribute to our church. So that's a great thing. So that's happening next Sunday. So speaking of that, we have wonderful volunteer opportunities here at Unity. And we'll have a sign-up volunteer sheet here in the lobby. What's great about that, if there's something that you feel called to maybe help us with, we would be grateful for that. Some of the things that we could use assistance with is the fun, food, and entertainment committee. That helps out in the kitchen to bring different snacks, different things like that. People to do flowers, ushers and greeters, buildings, ground, and yard maintenance, which will be really more for the spring. Decorating and bulletin boards, which we could definitely use your help next Sunday after church to put up the Christmas tree, and also in the bookstore. So Miss Pat would be able to help you about that. We know you're responsible for that, but it's always good to have support, so that's good. And we want to publicly thank all of our volunteers. Tony, thank you for running the Zoom. Deb, thank you for running the sound today. WG, Kelsey, thank you for your beautiful music. We are so grateful for each and every one of you. So God bless you guys. All right, let me see if I got everything here. One more thing. If you have a change of address or change of phone number or change of email, please write that down and put it in the offering bag as it goes through so we can make those updates in church. And think and speaking about the offering, really be thinking about what you would like to give for this season of giving. for our Thanksgiving offering today. Be thinking about that maybe during the service. You'll have an opportunity to be able to give. In Unity Church, let me commend you and thank you for all of your giving and for the way that you love and you support all that we do. We are truly grateful. We could not do what we do without you guys here. So what's your homework this week? You're going to invite somebody to bring them back next Sunday. Yeah? Can I get at least a few nods? Yeah? Thank you. Thank you, Roxanne. I appreciate that. Very good. Hey, guys, if you will, let's all stand to our feet together today. We're going to do our oneness blessing and our greeting here at Unity Church. It goes something like this. The Christ in me greets the Christ in you, and we work together for the glory of God. Go shake somebody's hand today. To turn to page 153. It's right there underneath the chair in front of you. 153. And in honor of Thanksgiving, we're going to count our blessings today. And speaking of blessings, happy anniversary to Bob and Don today. 13 years. We love you guys. We love you. Happy anniversary. Page 153.
When upon life's billows you seem tempted, tossed. When you feel discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has.
Sing it out today.
Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. Count your many blessings. See what God has.
153 on the last verse.
When your life seems empty, it is so untrue. There's a mighty presence making all things new. Miracles take place whether you may be. Proving that God's love is and He is with you constantly. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God hath done.
God, we have so much to be thankful for today, Lord. Thank you for health and strength to be able to be here in your beautiful house today. God, we pray for Pastor Elizabeth as she will prepare to come and speak in just a few moments. And God, that you would give her exactly the message that we need to hear. And God, we present ourselves to you with open hearts, with open minds, and open lives. And God, we are grateful. Amen. You may be seated.
Say thanks for the things that you've done for us, things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for us. The voices of a million angels
folks. I needed that song. We're going to a place that we haven't really gone maybe before today, because what is happening right here, right now on planet Earth is we're waking up to a whole new era of time, and we're being pushed out of the womb of our past. We're being birthed into that spiritual consciousness. And I have been whacked back and forth with these songs on, as you know, on Easter, because I know that it's about the resurrection power of Jesus. It's about salvation. It's about not feeling guilty that he went to a cross. It's not about the blood sacrifices. We know it. What's happened, I've just got to download, forgive me. I'm excited with all of you being here. And hold it, the right words come out. I know they will. Forget me. What is happening right now is we're leaving two different ages in the past. We're leaving that orthodox place. Some of you, us are, and I think a great majority is going to start breaking through this energy field that's been held, holding everybody back. There are the teachings of the Catholicism that has been for ages. Then there's the Christian movement, and going into that charismatic Christian, which is lifting us up into this next field of energy where you feel the spirit, you feel the music, you feel the energy pouring through you. And then we're still stuck in the womb. We're still stuck in the past. We're still stuck in the old teachings. And our hearts right now are saying, I want more. I want more. It was so exciting for me last week to come together with people. The refrigerators were packed full. People brought things in. I mean, it was wonderful fellowship. And here I was, if you got that little text or that little whatever I sent out, I started writing. And I wanted to send it out to everybody to say thanks. Because I saw love in manifestation. I saw abundance in manifestation. I know Tony and I, like I said in that writing, I'll try to cut it short, but for those that hadn't heard it, I thought there'll probably be about 20 or 30 people here. And so I made sure I had 36 sandwiches so we'd have something to eat. And then I thought, well, I've got to get a tray for vegetables, you know, finger food. I got to get that. So I got this nice tray in the top. Okay, if it's just a couple of people and nobody bring anything, we got something to eat. Within moments after the doors were open, both refrigerators were totally full of food, plus things were on the table and people in there just helping, just volunteers coming forward. And it was so beautiful. And I thought of the loaves and fish. And I thought, my gosh, if food can bring people in, let's do it every Sunday. But what it was, people were coming in the door that had no idea what was going on. Friends that had been here for a long time had met for dinner and decided, one of them said, hey, I'm going to Unity tomorrow. And the other said, well, we haven't been there in years. We'll meet you there. So things like that happen without people knowing that that's what we're doing. So to me, that just opened my heart up, and I was so grateful. And then for the beautiful Thanksgiving songs that were being played, and for to God be the glory. When he started singing that, it was like, whoa, it was an upload, not a download, I think, because everything started coming in alignment with what I've been trying to reach for and didn't even know how. We're going through the place now that we're coming in with union with the divine. Jesus did play one of the most important roles ever to be played on planet Earth as a human being. Bear with me. For those that are in my old consciousness of my father and mother's upbringing, of traditional teachings, Jesus came in. He came in as human and divine. You came in as human and divine. It's physical and spiritual. But he was one that came in, and his teachings were, come and follow me. Come and follow me. Come and follow me, and all that I do, you shall do also, and greater things than I'm going to do in this lifetime here on earth, you're going to do greater things. Well, right there is where we got kind of sidetracked in theology. Because humanity began to teach that Jesus was the only Son of God, the truth, he is the Son of God. But he came to tell you who you are. And what did he point you to? Oh, I'm the greatest guru there is, honey. You come down and bow down before me. Whoops, you can't touch me. I'm too holy. You bow before me. No, that's not what he did. He said, come, follow me. Come. And I will show you the way to the kingdom of God. I'll show you the way to the Father. And when you started singing to God be the glory, there was Jesus standing before me saying to God be the glory. Yeah, Elizabeth, you got it. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things that he did. And Jesus is saying, I am an instrument just like you. I am an instrument here just like you. And as I walked this earth and people followed me and they picked up my teachings and stuff, they begin to bow down to my physical form. They begin to hunger and thirst for the things that I gave them, the physical things. And how long is it going to be? How long is what my heart's been saying? How long until we can step out of the physical mentality that we're in and step into that freedom that Jesus came to save us from, the bondage of the carnal mind, or that mass consciousness that we're in this world? There is a thought form that covers this earth, and it's the one mind of the collective consciousness. Did you get that? You live in the collective consciousness of humanity. I live in the collective consciousness of humanity. Jesus came knowing he was in the collective consciousness of humankind. His greatest challenge was to not look at the appearance, but to look to God, to look to that divine consciousness, to look to the divine. So why did he daily, you would find him, some of you were with him too, I believe in reincarnation, we walked with him, we talked with him, but half the time he wasn't with us. He was somewhere in the mountains, he was somewhere in the desert, he was somewhere tucked away somewhere, what, doing what? Talking to his father, talking to God. Hours on end he did this. Breaking through this mass consciousness to bring forth that light of who he said we are. You are the light of the world, and he understood he came to bring light. He came to bring wisdom. He came to bring knowledge, not of the things of this world. He said, I'm not of this world. We're not of this world. We're not here right now to be a part of the world. We're here to bring forth the spirit of the truth of who we are and to be the light in the world as he was the light in the world. He walked among men and women doing the things that would plant seeds in our soul so that one day we would wake up and remember. We place it all on him. The doctrine wasn't wrong that he is the way, that he gave his all for us. But it was so you could give your all also and be just like him. Just like him. So what are these steps, Lord? How can we get to that place of knowing? It's when you come to that knowledge and you go deep, deep, deep within and make that connection with the divine self. It's when you start going to that mountaintop where Jesus took Peter, James, and John to the mountaintop. And as they're watching, they begin to see this brilliant light that was surrounding Jesus. And they saw him speaking with, I think it was Moses and Elijah, and they were talking. They were seeing him working in a higher dimension. And truly, they wanted to worship him. You know, look, we've never seen anything like this before. But what was transpiring is that he personally made that connection so close, and that understanding that he and the Father were one. And he was teaching people that when that happened, his light began to expand outward. All that he was began to be transmuted into the physicalness of the carnal mind, and the self was being illumined. And then he had to come back down off the mountain. I know some of you have been at that place where just love lifted you, love lifted you, love lifted you. The divine love of God took you to a place that you felt from then on you would be walking on water. You've seen miracles in your life. You've seen blind eyes open or deaf ears that could hear, or the lame starting to walk, or somebody that's in ICU dying. You were there holding those prayers, and voila, look at the magic. And now with everything that's happening right now, it's like, where are my prayers, Lord? Why can't I even get past the ceiling with them? It's because we're still thinking in the carnal or in the natural mind. What's happening? That I can't be free of all this stuff. What's going on? It's a process, folks. Spirituality is a process, not only this lifetime, but many lifetimes, to get you to right where we are in this very moment. And living in the very moment is going to help us evolve in ways we never even dreamed of. It's going to bring us into that spiritual birth that Jesus said, know you not that you must be born again? You must be born again. And he wasn't saying, come here and bow down to me and say, I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior, and thank you very much. It's more than that. He said, you come with me and I'll show you how to make the connection. I will show you how to make the connection. And you're going to make it through pain and suffering. You're going to have to go walking all those miles that I walked. You're going to have to go to Golgotha. What's Golgotha? It's the place of the skull. You're going to have to go into your mind, and you're going to there be crucified. And what's going to happen when you enter in those places? You're going to start seeing that there are going to be people that will talk about you. Out of the woodwork, things will come. You'll find those that will stab you in the back and betray you. But guess what? Then it takes you into yourself, where you have to look at the darkness in you. Where in some time have I offended somewhere else, whether I knew it or not? And whether we recognize it or not, we've all walked those paths. And we have to look at ourselves too. And it's not easy. It's not easy. I'm beating myself up because I can't do more in this life. I can't do more. And I realize I need you. The cells in the body of God have to come together to begin to work, because we all have different gifts. We all have different gifts that God has already given us. And together we can move mountains. Together we can change this world. Because I remember 12 men that were dedicated. But even in that time of hardship, people ran away when they thought they were going to have to face death. We have divided this country. That's not just this country. The whole world has divided for fear. Fear that they're going to die. But we wouldn't come together. And even when we come together, we decide somebody's not thinking the way I am, or somebody doesn't like me, or somebody said something bad about me, and I'm not going to speak to them anymore. That's what the negative forces want, because in division, you will not stand. You will fall. And I found myself falling this week. I fell down on my knees because so many people are hurting. So many people are dividing. So many people are in pain financially, mentally, emotionally. All these levels. And I couldn't do anything about it. And I thought I could. All these years, I thought I could make a difference, Lord. Help me make a difference in just one person's life. That they'll go on and obtain that high calling of God. Let me see it. Let me see it. And when I started looking at it this week, and I felt so helpless, I fell down on my knees in the kitchen and I started crying. Huge tears just rolling down my face. And I could feel all this energy coming up, anguish, because I'm not enough. I'm not enough for this world. And when I did, I heard, as above, so below. As within, so without. It didn't register what I was hearing. I was in so much pain. I just wanted to be taken care of. Help these people. Do something, God. And as I did, I found myself standing up. And it was like all the heaviness in my heart and my body began to sort of soak away and went into the earth. I felt much lighter. But then it was like as above, so below, as within, so without. And the energy from Mother Earth started coming up through my body. And it went up and up and out and out. And then ripples of energy began to come in. Have you ever been in that stillness? And it's like different colors or different vibrations. You can feel it as it begins to come in you and go through you. Been there before? Just the energy just coming. Feel it. Well, it was coming back again. I used to experience every day of my life for years that. And somehow it seems like that feeling had dissipated some. And I felt so unworthy and so lacking. Where's that connection? And in that moment, I began to recognize that as within, as so without, as above, so below. In this birth of this new era of time, of spiritual growth, we're going to understand more and more about we are the ones that has to do our part to obtain that place where Jesus did. So what did he do? What did he do? He broke through the stratosphere, for lack of a better word. What's the stratosphere? It's that which is above the earth. Okay, we get that. But that's where we're ready to stop. Because we're getting this with the natural mind. I understand what that stratosphere is. You know, you're breaking free of the earth. You're going into a higher place. Yeah, we can take jets, rockets, and go above the stratosphere, right? But Jesus came to tell us about a different place. He came to tell us about going to the kingdom. Not a kingdom that we thought was way out there in the sky somewhere where a God is out there that looks like a big man in the sky. But he's telling us about the divine that is in us, the living God in you, the living God in me, the living God in all of us. And Jesus couldn't take you to that place, but he could give you the symbology. Just like right now, I can tell you we're going and we're going to break through the stratosphere. Leave you there. And where do? We still keep going round and round in the wilderness of our own stinking thinking, trying to figure it out. Jesus said the Holy Spirit will come and he will lead you into all truth. That is the teacher, because my physical form has to leave. Or if I stayed into this 2022 and beyond, you would be bowing down to me seeking material wealth, material healing. You would be seeking the gold, the frankincense, the everything that is of a material level. Spirit could only speak, or God could only speak in that time to us, most of humankind, on an earthly level. What does a man know except of himself? How can you know spiritual things unless you are spiritually operating in that frequency? We're just frequency. We're like frequencies. We're energy fields. So right now in this age, we're standing at that point where it's time to grow. Grow how? Grow spiritually. Grow in wisdom and in knowledge. And it's just like a teacher will come to you and can teach you all things. And we can read books and we can have all information. But if it's not coming from the Spirit, or it's not that they're not spiritual, that's not what we're saying. It's that that spirit in you has to align with the truth that's there, that wants to reveal itself to you and through you. And it's right within you, working with you, or you wouldn't even be hearing what I'm saying. We hear, but we can't hear. We see, but we can't see. But that energy has been laying dormant all this time. So now Jesus is awakening, or the Christ is awakening you. And when that energy started to come through, and I was feeling that weight being lifted. I felt the energy coming down, and I felt like I grabbed hold of something and began with all my might to pull it down and to pull it down and to pull it down. And all of a sudden, the tears were still coming, and I began to speak in another language. It's not something that that's different for me. It's that baptism of the Holy Spirit that I experienced ages ago. And in that, I had no comprehension what was going on, except it was pouring out of me. The tears were pouring out of me. And there was a part of lifting that energy up is what happened. And it lifted into the heavens. And then it began to come down and give me such great peace. It was a rainy, rainy week to begin with and cold. And I remember people would call me, or Tony, I remember especially, called, and he's down in the dumps. I couldn't go there with him. I couldn't. I had to tell him about the joy that being alive and how wonderful life was. And I just couldn't go there with him. And then now I realized what's happened. I was sharing it some with Troy this morning, and I recognized I had to get to that place of pain. I had to get to that place of suffering. I had to get to that place of knowing Elizabeth cannot satisfy somebody else's needs. I can't transform anything for you except if I hold it for you and you hold it with me. We can transform it for a period of time. We can do it for a period of time. And just like I found myself talking a couple of weeks ago about why did the dead come back? I guess I was asking my question back then, and they were, God hears everything we're saying. But what was coming up is, why would Jesus raise someone only to see them die again? It was to show us the power of the living God that was in him. But we can't do it for anybody else. That's why they died, because they couldn't stay in the spiritual energy that Jesus was helping them to hold. He would say, your faith has made you whole. You believe in what I'm telling you. You know what I'm telling you is truth. And you join with that in your own self, the divine in your own self. And you walk if you're lame. Abundance is opened up to you. All these things are already given to you if you know that you have to do the work. You have to do that work and come and follow me as I went to that place of the skull and crossed out this world. I overcame the world, you see. If I overcame the world, you can do it also, was his message. And so when you sing to God, be the glory, that's the same message Jesus brought to us. It's not to Jesus be the glory when he was here. That's not what he asked. It was to God be the glory, because God has this plan of letting all of us have a free will to do what the heck we want. And then someday, for the burdens and the heaviness of all this to be so hard, you don't even want to live. I hate to admit it, I was there that day. I felt if I can't help anyone, if this church is falling apart, and I don't have a part in it, and I can't help it grow, God, take my life. I don't want to stay here. I'm no good. But then to realize it's not about us. It's not about me. Anybody want to take this, you know, start helping out, you're more than welcome. But it's about, you can't do it. Whoever thinks that they can do, bring everything together, it's not true. None of this is true. It's only God can bring it about. Only God can grow a church. Only God can bring a people together. What happened when the Christians got together after the baptism of the Holy Spirit? Thousands of people woke up. Thousands of people woke up. Was it just because of that person or those couple of disciples? It was more than that. And in that last day, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men and old women shall dream dreams. They'll begin to see the truth of what spirituality is about. They'll know who they are in God. They'll know that they're all sons and daughters of God. We've been taught that Jesus is the only Son of God, but all of us are in that sonship, folks. Every single one of us. And what's keeping us out of it is we don't believe and we don't know and we don't want to walk that walk that it takes to get us there. But even if you don't want to do it, guess what? There's no judgment on it. God loves you just like you are. You take all the time you want to go out there and live a life in the world. But the world has nothing to offer you. Because what you think you can get in the world, it's not even it's not even a little tiny speck of what the divine blesses you with when you discover I'm back home in the Father's house. And I'm not talking about being dead, folks, in the physical. I'm talking about bringing the kingdom of God to earth. That's what Jesus told us to do. And I think that's what I was doing, is bringing a part of the kingdom into my consciousness when I was pulling down that energy. And when I did, all of a sudden, I began to speak in that unknown tongue. And then after that, I was feeling so happy, I began to sing. And you know, I don't want to sing, not even for me in the kitchen. Well, I'll do it then. But after that, it was not like it left me. The interpretation of it came, not consciously, because the mind didn't have anything to do with what was happening that day. Not a thing. It didn't understand any of that babbling that was coming out of my mouth. If I tried to focus on it, it wouldn't have made any sense to me. But the mind kind of subsided, and my ears were still hearing it. But all of a sudden, song came. And it was like God, him, herself, I love that, was speaking directly to me of the blessings. The blessings are right here for us all. And a deep, deep, settled peace. Oh, gosh, when I was walking in that energy for a while, it was like when I finally got up on the skis, water skiing. I'd fallen thousands of times, it seemed like. I just didn't have the hang of it. How can I do this? I'd fall backwards. But I finally got it. And after I practiced getting up for a while, I had it. I probably was going to ski on one ski pretty soon. But I knew all the waves that came my way, I had it handled. But guess what? There's this speedboat came by one day, and it knocked me for a loop, and the waves came in. That's what happens. Probably less than 48 hours, I was back on my knees praying. Why am I telling you this? Part of me really doesn't know, but yet another part does. Because this is what happens. It's not all flowers and roses and, you know, rainbows and unicorns. It's about walking a real walk and being so dedicated that I'm willing to go to that place where I can practice the presence of God, where I've arrived there in my full consciousness or not, where I can practice holding my tongue and my opinions, where I can practice only lifting somebody up and never tearing anybody down. When I practice that enough, then I will be ready and you will be ready to go for this next place of going to that mountaintop. And when we're on the mountaintop, people will look at you and say, isn't he an angel? What do you know, that person or that person, don't you think they're just an angel? An earth angel. They just bless you when they come in the room, don't they? There's just this likeness about them that you can be down in the dumps and you feel like you're just lifted up. And then for you, you begin to see the divinity in others at that time. And you see the pain that they're having. And then you'll understand what my friend Preston used to tell me that took so long to grasp it. I can hold that for you till you can hold it for yourself. I behold the Christ in you.
I see God in you. And I'll hold it for you until you can hold it for yourself. When we come to that place of knowing, we're at that center of that energy where all the darkness is falling around us. We can't seem to get out. We're ready to give up everything. We're ready to turn loose of our whatever's going on in our life. Just help me have freedom, Lord. You will find yourself pushing through the stratosphere. Pushing through the stratosphere, just like Jesus did, and going beyond the worldly consciousness. But what he was showing, it's pushing through the stratosphere of that's what's blocking the human consciousness and the human being from ever believing that it's separate from God. What if you went through that little hole of consciousness like Jesus did? And lived continuously in knowing, truly knowing this personality, the I of who I think I am, and the I of who I truly know God is. It's all one. It's all one. You wouldn't be concerned with the things of the world. You would be concerned in bringing the spiritual truths out of each other, out from each other. Ages ago, I heard this little voice when I was asking, what in the world am I doing here? Guess when I first started going into ministry. What I heard is you're a bridge builder. For people coming from the natural mind, I didn't realize, but that's what they're talking about, from one consciousness to the divine consciousness. You're a spiritual midwife. Ooh, I like that. Here to see you birth Christ in you. To see that pure soul. We're going into the Christmas season of Mary. You are that Mary. When we come to that Mary mind that believes what the divine is saying to you, that knows that the divine has overshadowed you, and you begin to hold all this in your heart. Because you know, when you start talking these kind of things, somebody's going to say, oh, that's crazy. What's wrong with you? What are you listening to any of that for? You conceived an idea. You conceived something different about spirituality. And you didn't conceive it through man-made doctrines. You know truth that the man-made doctrines and the hierarchy didn't give to you? What's wrong with you? Forget it. There's no such thing. It's crazy talk. But Jesus talked about the Holy Spirit coming to you. And that Holy Spirit is now overshadowing us to impregnate us with that new life, the life of the Christ in you, being born in you and through you. This is where humanity is right now. No wonder why we're so in such pain and agony. We're birthing a whole new era of time where we can come to know the truth. And it is the truth that Jesus brought to us. Yes, he's a savior. He's a savior of, as you are, of your own stinking thinking. This is where we're standing right now, I believe, folks. As we learn to be in the moment. It's time to move. It's time to move. To stop sitting on a seat or somewhere talking about where we're going to, what's going to happen, what's going to be out there tomorrow or the future and the next day. We're making room as we turn loose of the past, the old. And don't be afraid to go to your heart, because the truth is there. In the stillness, you will find freedom. In the stillness, you will find wisdom and knowledge. I'm hearing an old song. You've got to move, you've got to move. You've got to move, you've got to move. When the Lord gets ready, you've got to move, you've got to move, you've got to move. There was Daniel in the lion's den. He didn't think anybody was even his friend. But when the Lord got ready, he had to move, he had to move, he had to move. He stood there. You know, all these things, they're symbols of telling us it's about you and God. 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 And then when we all get that connection and that alignment that we can hold daily, hold hourly, all this, then we begin to move together. We begin to move together. And that's when the kingdom of God will come into the individual lives. And then we recognize we're a cell in the body of God. And then we'll each take our place. Not trying to knock somebody else off of their position to try to get their place. Because when people need to move in a different direction, God will take them there as we begin to trust and obey. It's recognized and becoming aware or illumined. The Indian philosophy, India, when the East meets the West, I'm hearing, so shall the coming of the Lord. It's when philosophies begin to, right now I'm feeling, when the Eastern teachings, the Western teachings, and other teachings which filter all in that begin to come together, the true knowledge will be open to us. You'll understand reincarnation. You'll understand the resurrection and the life. And you won't be afraid to share your opinion and your wisdom and knowledge. Because every single one of us is a piece of the puzzle. And your walk in life has not been an accident. We've had these pains and sorrows so we could let them go. Lift them up and let them be transmuted. That's what I got this morning. As that pain was being lifted up, the heaviness, the darkness in your life, in my life, and us recognizing only God can transmute this energy. But then recognizing we are the great alchemist of the world right now. Turning things to gold or silver? No. Turning that material life into pure life, pure love, pure essence. And when it touches those higher places, even beyond the stratosphere in here, it begins to rain down on us and fill us with peace, love, wisdom, knowledge, power, strength, zeal, imagination. All that the Father has is already ours. So that's what meditation is about. That's what prayer is about. I'm here. Prayer is getting in the habit of talking to the divine, however you see the divine. Talking to the divine daily, maybe hourly, not just weekly. Making that connection. And then one day, that heaviness of a life, that's how alcoholics and drug addicts and all kinds of things get to that place. That they want to give it all up. I'm going to kill myself. I got to get out of this. I got to get out. I can't take it. I can't take it. I can't take it any longer. My world is becoming so small. My body is just squishing me. My mind is closing in on me. I want freedom. Yeah, you're wanting freedom. But freedom comes then as we surrender all that to that higher power. We surrender. Because of myself, I can't handle whatever's going on. And that's when the transition begins. And you feel that uplift. Some of us have been in groups where we were seeking that relief. And it lasted until when? Until we went back into that old carnal consciousness, that old way of life. In God's patience, go back and forth as long as you want. But only we, with the help of releasing and releasing, can that energy be transmuted and come back as powerless, that we can live this every day. Peace, love, blessing, each and every one of you. And I truly do behold the Christ in you, no joke about it. This is God's seeing you. This is God's life in you. And it's time for growth. And we need to water that spiritual essence, that spirit that's within us. And if we see anything, any weed in there that's beginning to grow up to choke that life that's in, weed the garden. Pull out that negative thought. Pull out that negative action. And just grow it. I had a whole lot of notes today. Actually, I had a notebook full of them. But that's not where I'm at. That song led me someplace else. So let's just close our eyes for a moment. There's a little thing that actually listening to Sri Sri this last week, he brought something to our attention. When we breathe in and out, that is the breath of God. That's life is our gift. But so often it goes up one nostril and down the other in different directions. But when you're being aware of your breath, what happens? You breathe through both nostrils at one time. You pull it in. You hold it for a few seconds. And you release it. You breathe in and you release. You breathe in. As you continue to take deep breaths in and out, has anything changed? Can you feel just a little more peace? Has the outside world faded just a little bit as you focus on the breath? Just focus on the breath. When you face troubles or anxiety, pause and in the middle of it, focus on the breath. And begin to live in the present. For living in the present leads us to freedom. Today, I release regrets over my past events. I wish at times I could go revisit and undo those things. And I say no to worries about the future now. For over the years, I have learned that trying to live in the past or in the future, just finds my attention and keeps me in a prison of distraction. I find spiritual freedom by living mindfully in the present moment of every moment. Distracting thoughts and feelings fall away as we focus our attention on whatever we are choosing to do. Time then can expand until there is only the eternal now stretching out before us. In this place of mind, in this present, we can discover our oneness with God, a brand new. We are receptive then to the nudges of that guidance of the Spirit within that is showing us the way forward now. When freedom and with gratitude, I allow the path of my higher good to come my way. Out of my distress, I call on the Lord in Psalms 118:5. And the Lord answers me, and he places me on the path, that place, that path that will lead me to the higher calling. Thank you, God, for this moment that you allowed me to share with others as you have shared with me. May each individual begin to discover that truth that you've already given me, that love that they already are. May they forgive the past and live in every moment as that brilliant light in this world. Jesus, you said, I have overcome the world. And as you overcome the world, you called us to overcome the world too. And we read in Corinthians, that when I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. For the majority of humanity, up until this time, we have been thinking as a child. We couldn't understand the things of spirit. But you knew that day would come when we began to grow in spiritual awareness. And in those moments, you will see us putting away childish things of hate, of anger, of division, of jealousy, of greed. We'll release it and step into the moment and beyond into that future that has already been prepared for us, that eyes have not seen nor ears even heard the things that you've already prepared. We're looking forward to that moment when we all unite as one. Indeed. Thank you. And thank each and every one of you for staying with us this day. Hey, it's right at 12 o'clock. My head just said, I bet it's 12:30. That's the human part of it. But thank you, every single one of you, for being here and being drawn to this place. Together, I know wonderful things are going to happen in your life. As long as we keep there, keep on going, God's right here with us. So if this has been a blessing for you, and you would like to give a donation to keep holding our doors open and the message going forward. But I'm looking for that day that message is coming, that each of us are sharing this without any fear to your friends and your family. We all need to do our part in whatever way we're called. And divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And I am grateful, Lord. I am grateful. To God be the glory. Thank you. And for all the Christians out there that are, you know, hiding away in your house listening to this, don't be afraid to come. This is not about following a doctrine or anything else. It's about following your heart and finding truth that's going to set us all free. It's not about a different kind of thing that's happening. It's just your awakening. That's why you're looking for more. You're looking for more. So don't be afraid to come together in love. Give thanks for this visible evidence of the bounty of God. It's already here. I send it forth with love and joy to do its perfect work. And I recall years ago when I was in lack consciousness and could barely make the bills, I began to give thanks that I could pay that bill and bless that person, that they had finances to bless somebody else and pay their bills and so on. So when you, that's a little thing that I'm just sharing with you. If you don't begrudge what's going out, but you bless it to send out what you got, guess what? It comes back. Well, for me, it did, and I know it is for you. So if you'd like to come together and close with the peace song, hold hands or not, however you feel led to.